Yeah, guys, today we are going to discuss about data mining techniques and data mining methodologies. This is a topic of discussion. You can refer this material also. Even I will be walking through this material, especially after the completion of overview about data mining and data mining methodologies. Look at here. Your data can be arrived from database, data warehouse. Data warehouse is different from database. Collection of database will be treated as data warehouse. And also, if you consider database, you can deal with either one particular database. NoSQL or SQL or columnar or graphical database, whatsoever may be. But when it becomes data warehouse, it's going to become collection of databases. Whereas database will deal with the collection of tables or relations. Data warehouse will deal with the collection of databases. Then what other medium or source of data? World Wide Web, other info repository. It can be anything, healthcare data, other info repository. All the medical information will be available with the hospitals. So any info repository, it could be anything. So our HR detail. Their own firm, they will maintain all the HR detail. Using that HR detail, people are working on human attrition or employee attrition rate. So what is the meaning of attrition is how quick employee joins into the institution, how quick he relieves attrition. What is the cause for relieving? How we can retain employees? So those kind of things people are working for. So that all will be helpful in order to analyze, in order to predict. Then salary prediction. That HR analytics will be useful for salary prediction, attrition rate analysis, or employee retaining retirement analysis. So any other kind of analytics, if you want to go through manpower analysis, related matter or knowledge analysis, skill analysis or project, as well as human resource mapping, number of required project and human resource, then mapping need to be done. That analysis, everything need to be maintained in the repository. This would become internal. All these component can be the source of data, or any one component also could be the source of data. All together, you will be going towards the very first step, data gathering or data acquisition or data collection. Then from the data gathering, data acquisition, data collection, you need to be in the process of cleaning, integration and selection, because various different source of information you are collecting, different format of information you are collecting, then you supposed to work on cleaning the data, subsequently integrating several sources of data together. Then you need to go for data selection or data transformation, etc. Any technique you can patch there, not necessarily to imitate the same. Here itself you can say data transformation, data pre-processing, data cleaning, data integration, feature selection, whatsoever you know, all together you can give here. Then database or data warehouse server. So how typical business analytical model works, then all those together, you'll be going for data warehouse server. Then from the, otherwise you can call data mart. Data mart is what exactly you want. That alone you will be segregating out, or ETL tool. The almost we can say these two component together, ETL tool. ETL tool role would be the same, whatsoever you are discussing. Next, extract, transform, load, ETL tool. So these three would be the best example for ETL. After that, you will be going for data mining engine. So this does lot of role: clustering, prediction, grouping, segregating. These all those component carried out by data mining engine. Next, subsequently, pattern evaluation. Any kind of pattern you want to analyze, then pattern evaluation, then user interface. These two will be integrating or communicating with knowledge base. What is a knowledge base? Set of rules or parameters, or the learning weights, the logic behind decision making, all those together can be said as knowledge base. So this is how a typical analytical model works in the business scenario. Next, coming to data mining and the methodologies technique. This is overall process, how the data mining is happening. So next we are going for micro level. What are all the data mining techniques? Very few only it is addressed here. Don't think that this is exhaustive. This is selective. Since it is available on the internet, this picture attracted me, I have brought in. It doesn't mean that you have only these all. Classification, association, prediction, clustering, sequential pattern, decision trees. So these are all. Even you can go for regression. See, that is famous. It is not at all included. In the examination point of view, you can put it in that form of a chart itself. How you can prepare a chart? Again, you can go with a different way of chart. That chart also I have discussed with you. You can go for supervised learning. From the supervised learning, what are all the techniques available? Then you can go for unsupervised learning. Then you can go for reinforcement learning. Then within that, you can categorizing everything. When the moment you bring supervised learning, numerical prediction, two topics, then it will be into label prediction or categorical prediction. You can use any kind of terminology, it doesn't matter. So you can categorize it into two different. Then if you come under numerical prediction, linear or regression, then Morse algorithm, then what not, even random forest is useful for linear regression, random forest regressor. Random forest classification, classifier, there are two flavor, random forest classifier, random forest regressor, support vector machine. If you know about each algorithm, you can write even a couple of lines, at least you can discuss a couple of lines. Then subsequently, K nearest neighborhood, KNN is also useful for regression. So these are all the few techniques you can keep discussing. If you want to touch upon ensemble technique, you can even discuss about stacking method, voting method. So you can discuss anything, any kind of ensemble technique, boosting method. This all fall into ensemble technique. Then you need to talk about label prediction or categorical prediction. Within underneath, what are all the algorithm you can discuss? First, you need to list out few, very few. Then you can go for description. Yes, short amount of information you can produce in the exam point of view. Then the moment it comes, the famous algorithm is logistic regression. Although it seems to be regression, it is meant for classification. Why that regression is used? Again, internally, the logit function make use of the regression equation. That is the reason that name itself has come. Decision tree. Even the decision tree is useful for decision tree regressor is also available. Decision tree regressor. How random forest regressor is available? Similarly, decision tree regressor is also available. It is a correct word only. It is technological word, so it gives error. So nothing to worry about that. Decision tree. Then if you come into this particular portion, these all are applicable for categorical. Not only those all. These all absolutely suitable for categorical prediction. So the moment you come into unsupervised learning, it is termed as clustering. The famous algorithm can be said as clustering. Then types of clustering and all, you no need to talk, because this is business point of view, you no need to worry about technicality. So what are all the clustering techniques available? If you wish, you can go for hierarchical clustering, k-means clustering, fuzzy c-means clustering, whatsoever may be the clustering, you know all the clustering technique you can elicit underneath the clustering technique. How much you want to put forth for this question, depending upon the time and depending upon your knowledge, you can go ahead. But overall, you should be in the position to give some skeleton for the data mining techniques. Then subsequently, association, rule mining. Then pattern mining. Then sequential mining. These are all the technique will fit into unsupervised learning. So minimum you need to bring any couple of things. At least you should bring a couple of algorithm into every skeleton. Then one more technique is also available, semi-supervised learning. Just you bring at least a holistic picture. You just give majorly machine data mining techniques categorized into four different techniques. You can say 1, 2, 3. This is 3. Then I can call it as AB. So these all into. Then fourth technique is said to be semi-supervised technique. Then reinforcement learning. So at least you can give these all. Recommendation engine, all the recommendation engine bots. Without this, now business is not at all possible. Recommendation engine. These all works with the support of some algorithm of previously listed out. I'm just listing out from my brain. I'm not referring anything. So the same way, you should be in the position to talk about a couple of lines at least. Reinforcement learning, bots, and recommendation engine. These all are the best. All the chatbots. Without chatbot, no site. If you get into any of the website, immediately you will be getting a pop-up chat window. So very simple chatbot, I'm telling. Chatbot had gone to the extent level. There are several intelligent chatbots are available. You look at a Paradise Biryani. The moment you book the Paradise Biryani, you will be getting the chat window. So that no human being intervened there. Suitable to that business case, people have come out with chatbot. So that chatbot is meant for only Paradise Biryani. It works intelligent only for that specific domain. You can't expect from the Paradise Biryani chatbot, you cannot have a conversation about academics. So this is the meaning of chat, chatbot. Then recommendation engine, all Google engine, Google, all the Google product, be it Google search engine, YouTube, Google homepage, everywhere recommendation is possible. Even when you are start writing in the Google Doc, even mailing, recommendations started coming. The moment I write, automatically it completes the sentence, the mail, body of the mail. Recent days, whenever we are drafting mail, we used to be frustrated. Nowadays it is cool because it is recommending grammatical mistake, spelling mistake, punctuation mistake, and at times it gives recommendation also. The first part of the speech is very good. The rest of the speech automatically recommended by the Google search engine. If the person drafts very poorly, then may not be possible. Similarly, when you are working with a Google Doc, when you are working with a Google Doc and Google Slides, everywhere recommendation comes. These are all a kind of recommendation engines. If you are looking at Quora, the moment you read one article, it will be listing out all the related articles, recommends. You might be interested in these all also. It will say the title. If you look at Amazon Netflix, if you look at even Amazon Basket also, it starts recommending a lot of products based on your past history of purchase or based on your gender. If you are a female, then it will be popping up with all the female wares. So these all termed as recommendation. Recent day, I can say recommendation is the biggest technique behind of every business success story. Chatbot is a kind of customer care. Of course, customer care is also essential. 30% of the business success or 50% of the business success comes from the customer care. Yes, it is possible. With the technology, even the customer care. Earlier, the BPO wala having lot of bottlenecks. The number of calls are more. Then call wait duration becomes more. Then people started feeling frustration. Nowadays, digitized voice has come. Through digitized voice, nowadays so many things are happening automatically with intelligent effect. So these are all those things. Smart handling, how to reduce that pipeline wait. Everything people working out, almost solved, I can say. So these are all the use case we can put forth. How these all the techniques helps in the business perspectives. How chatbot, if you look at how business profit or the quality or the overall business progression, the progress itself, how it became healthy with the support of chatbot, that itself you can write a report. That much plenty of use cases available. Similarly, recommendation engines, how that improves the business profit. You can write a very big use case. Plenty are available. Every technique has got its own business contribution, business adding a business value. Every type of analytics increases, boost the business value. These are all those things you need to put forth. You may need to articulate for this topic. There is no hard and thumb rule for this unit especially, because it's a kind of the overall learning progress of every students need to be reflected on the unit too. That's all I can say. Look at within that, at time you may get confused with association rule mining and sequential pattern mining. So these are all rule mining. It is called rule mining. Similarly, here it is called sequential pattern mining. So how these two mining techniques are differing each other, what circumstance, what you supposed to do, use, that is a part of discussion. Now we are going to look at here, what is the use of association rule mining? I'll just tell you. Mostly big supermarkets, if you look at, there are supermarket, you cannot even imagine how many item, DMart, look at any kind of supermarket. Yeah, largest amount of items, more and more collection of items going together in that particular shop. Plenty of customers every day comes and visits either online or offline, whatsoever. It is applicable for both, I mean to say, association rule mining. So where it is useful is, they will be fixing the price for every product. Then they will be introducing discount also for every product. How they will be introducing the discount, or how they will be not to introduce discount, this decision is purely or mostly based on association rule mining. Every customer tend to buy items one along with another. The moment we buy a butter, either eggs or jam, or butter, or kind of peanut butter, some choco butter, some kind of garnishing item people used to buy. So that association, which product is getting associated with what? Similarly, every customer tend to buy something with in an associated nature. So anybody comes for purchasing this, whether they are purchasing yet another item, this all gives a fair idea which product need to be waived with a discount, which product need not to be waived with a discount. Because of this discount, naturally they will be tempted to buy this one. So indirectly they will be promoting, they will be compensating the offer price given for product one with the product two. This is how they will be doing some tactics. So which product they will be giving offer, which product they are not giving offer, these all purely based on associativity. How this product purchase is associated with this. These are all the way people are predicting and fixing the sale price or discount price, whatsoever. Either fixing the sale price itself, one could be a minimal sale price, one could be a more, they may increase whatever the loss incurred in that, they will be compensating with that. Or expecting lesser profit at one product, they will be expecting more profit at another product. So that this kind of mining will be helpful for market basket analysis. One use case only I'm telling, don't think that it is limited to only market basket analysis. It has plenty of use cases. You can explore this alone. Sky is the limit. This is called co-occurrence relationship. So the primary purpose of association rule mining is meant for co-occurrence relationship. Look at here, buying cheese. The person is planning to buy a cheese. The same person tend to buy beer. So what is the meaning? Support 10, confidence 80. Always the moment you step into association rule mining, these votes are inevitable. It is mandatory to understand these two words, support and confidence. What is the meaning it you need to interpret is 10% of customers buy cheese and beer together. Then what is the 80? 80% of the time, 10% of the customer, 80% of the time, they will be buying the same combination. So that is the interpretation of support and confidence. Next, when you consider the sequential pattern mining, it has extensive. So web crawling, the best use case I can say, this is the word navigational patterns of user in the website. In a simple terminology, simple word, if you expect me to say, this is called web crawling pattern. What is the meaning is, if you look at my scenario, the moment I step into institution from the morning 8 o'clock till night 11, minimum 10 o'clock, maximum 12 o'clock, I'm into net. Constantly I'm interacting to the Google. Anything I prepare, class notes, external notes, whatsoever, or I am referring, or I am doing research, everywhere the moment any doubt comes, I don't even take patience, or I don't even put a patiently 10 minutes of time for thinking. Immediately I copy paste, I will read. If the first link, what it says, it is very tough to, very fuzzy to understand for me, I will switch over to next link. If none of the article pleasing me, I will go to YouTube. I am just revolving around every day. So this all web crawling, they will be understanding the pattern of the user. Similarly, whenever you are getting into Amazon website, customer crawling, they will be looking at. Even in the real-time shop, most of the abroad countries, they are installing camera. They are trying to understand emotional behavior or consumer, customer behavior. The moment you look at that product, how your facial expression goes, they are trying to measure through that. Similarly, customer behavior, they are trying to understand through your activity from one shelf to another shelf also. So what is the order you are maintaining? The moment customer comes in, how he or she reacts to each and every product shelf, and from where to where they are moving. So that all those insights will be helpful even for rearrangement, how they need to rearrange items. Suppose my product of interest is available in the first floor, immediately another product of interest is available in the third floor. It is very difficult or tedious. Especially in India, people are arranging based on segregation of category, male wear, female wear, or kitchen items, cookery items, professional items, cloth showroom, something, some kind of toys, kids zone. They'll put a kids zone, female zone, some kind of based on that item people are segregating and they are giving here. This is here the culture. Similarly, every country, they will be having shops in their own way or culture or internalization or the way of thinking. By the time also, this sequential pattern mining will be useful. There is no boundary. Sky is the limit again. How you think, which mining technique, where you want to interpret, you can interpret. Next is another interesting application or use of sequential pattern. Especially when you are into business analytics, you no need to worry about technicality a lot. A bit at least required, especially fourth unit, fifth unit, and second unit, you need to focus more on technicality. Second unit, third and sixth unit, if you look at, full of use case perspective only they have brought in. That is the way they have designed the syllabus. Four units full of technicality. You need to go in and out of the formula and algorithm and working principle. Third and sixth unit, you can go with the use case or understanding. Look at here. They will be predicting the pattern of customer behavior. What is the meaning is buying bed first and then buying bed sheet sometime later. So you imagine you are Amazon customer. So this sequential pattern mining is not related to association mining. This association rule mining is at a time, on the day, how you are behaving is the matter. The sequential pattern mining is sequentially or over the period of time. What is the meaning is, you are Amazon customer, you have Prime account or you have Amazon account or you are a Flipkart customer, whatsoever may be. So once in a month or once in 2 months, once in a week, once in a year, somehow you will purchase. So what item you are seriously you are purchasing? So especially, I don't know, they can't even predict about my pattern of purchase. I'll go during lockdown only I started groceries. Earlier I used to go for only clothes and only gift items and electronics items. Recently grocery also started. So these are all the way they will be predicting about the customer nature for the recommendation or giving an offer. Give offer and how we can attract customer and retain. That kind of thing they will be working on. Next, when it becomes another use case, you can look at this. What is the meaning of this is, given the sentence, this is a great movie. So it starts analyzing. It is sequential pattern mining is all. It is also useful into NLP, natural language processing. What it does is, it starts synthesizing part of speech tags. So this is the best method. It is used in pattern mining. Sequential mining will be part of pattern mining. So PRN, this, VP, this, DTA, JJ, great, NN movie. What is PRN is pronoun, VP, verb, DT, determiner, JJ, adjective, NN, noun. It can be anything. You can write directly noun, verb, determiner, adjective and pronoun. So in that order itself we can do. A set of such sequences can be used to find the language pattern that involves both part of speech tags and actual words. Almost I can say in general also you can write with the same use case you can write. It is useful in NLP. For the pattern mining or part of speech synthesis. Even we can say the same, it is useful for speech to text, text to speech. Both kind of application is essential. Understand. Natural language processing suitable for speech also text also. So when that part of speech analysis is involved with both speech to text or speech analysis, text analysis, text to speech, all the four kind of applications, it is most suitable kind of technique. This is what I wanted to convey today. For another 5-10 minutes, let us, this picture only I said, this I have shown you, but in the data modeling stages, that time of discussion I was showing you, but not in detail. I just shown this figure and I briefed about a couple of minutes how this picture attracted me from the LinkedIn. So look at here, complete holistic system architecture of machine learning, that's all. What are all the parts, modules, architecture, steps, process, interactions, interfaces, components? This is what they are discussing. See, when you look at data collected, acquired or bought, you can buy the data also. Generate, business people, they are buying the data. See, look at all the bank customer, credit card promoter, daily people are killing credit card promotion. How my number had gone to that guy? They will be purchasing with the Airtel, with the say, any kind of customer. This is how these people are doing yet another business, yet another avenue of income in addition to the plan, promotion plan or subscription plan. So acquire, generate, harvest, or you can augment. If it is not sufficient, you can go for augment. What is harvest? Web scraping. Web scraping is can be treated as harvesting the data from the web scraping. Next, you can immediately go with the data ingestion and data integration. Extract, transform, load, ETL, I said, ingestion technique. You can generate metadata. You can generate rules, or you can inject rules and metadata. You can do batch processing, real time, stream processing, time based processing, or replication with the data. Normally, whatever we are doing, almost equivalent to batch processing only. Offline only we are trying to do, that's all. Next, availability. Relational data or distributed data. Relational data you can pull out from the warehouse, or you can pull out from the data mart. What is data mart? After applying ETL on warehouse, you will be getting data mart. In-memory database. Then distributed data lakes, NoSQL, Hadoop, and cloud data. These all can be treated as distributed data base. Data governance. This is the one topic available later with your seminar. What are all the things it is included into data governance? Quality of the data, standards of the data, policies of the data, auditing of the data, security of the data, authentication of the data, profiling, roles, backup, retrieval, archive, purging. What is the meaning is governance, whether you are permitted to take backup also, whether you are permitted to retrieve, who can retrieve, who can backup, what is the level of authorization, authentication given for the person for the backup or for the, retrieval. So not everyone can go and retrieve. See, Amazon database, you and me cannot go and retrieve. Who are all the customers? Till date, we cannot understand who are all the customers of Amazon database. So that all governing policies need to be formulated. This governing data governance varies from countries to country. Every country data governance policy is different. In India, I can say too much liberal the policies are. That is the reason this guy is selling our data to that guy and earning money. That guy is selling our data to this guy. That guy is also eating our head. So these are all the trouble in our country. There are countries with data privacy policy, data governance itself, people paid $1 million, $1 billion. They got into a lot of trouble. Yeah, there are a lot of interesting stories available. You can read at data governance. Those who are preparing the topic data governance, you can come across with exciting stories. Plenty of stories available related to security, authentication issues, and the policies and standards of data governance. Then data preparation and analysis, pre-processing, data enrichment, data labeling, data selection, data segregation, develop, test, and validate. So these three you can do, feature extraction and EDA. So that is extra EDA process completely. You are going for data analysis process. Exploratory data analysis can be said as EDA. Hypothesis generation, question, or visualization. These are all the steps involved in the EDA process. Setting hypothesis is part of EDA. Setting or coining questions, or you can have both also. You can have set of hypothesis, or you can also you can have set of questions, problem statement, or you can have research question, investigation questions. Then visualization. Coming to here, then from these all, you need to go towards here, next level, experimental stage. You need to try with model 1 to model N. You may be extraordinarily luckiest person you to succeed with model 1. Otherwise, you need to try all the model. Data features, training, baseline criteria verification, AutoML. AutoML with the cloud, it is possible, not with ordinary AutoML. Or you can go for candidate evaluation, inference, tuning, hyperparameter tuning. These all you can do. Then save the model. Model saving. You can save entire model, or you can save weights or parameters, or experiments, or versions, or packaging. Pickle file is one of the way to package. Jar file is meant for Java. Pickle file is meant for Python. ONNX, HDFS. So what infrastructure you are working, or what DB, or what kind of language you are working, depending upon that, you need to choose the packaging method. There are very few available. There are plenty are available. So pickling method is one method. Then cloud computing. You can go for deploying into the cloud, or you can deploy into Docker, or you can load weights, or you can tag something. Then monitoring. This is where much more people need to be very alert and careful. This can be said as dashboard or control room. From the control room or dashboard, periodically feedback is given here. Look at this feedback. Drift, logging, rerun, performance analysis, registry analysis, versioning control, decay, all these tasks carried out by monitoring admin, we can say database administrator, something like that. The real life role of the employee, we can say. So every stage people are working on. Industry wants for specialist of every stage. At time they will be wanting for generalist of all the stage. Then model serving. What are all the way you can serve the model? You can use REST endpoints, Docker, web services, Kubernetes, store inferences, or Kubeflow, or API, a simple API. You can use normal JavaScript, then you can go for HTTP and the POST method, or you can go for Cloudic technique, then intelligent and insight. Why we are doing this all so far now from this stage to this stage? The primary purpose is for self-serving service or real-time insight, discovery, report analysis, or reporting, summary report, analytics, suitable for the mobile, in order to derive business intelligence. Then if at all web, you are going for deploying it to web, you need to have JavaScript, Flask, web framework, or React, or all the three you should know. Advanced technique, you can use for much more advanced insights. You can connect with Tableau also for more insights. So these are all the way, almost the holistic picture of data mining or the complete business intelligence. How, where it starts, where it works. These many components involved. Every component, computer science or a specialist role play is essential. With that note, I just quickly recap. You would have understood what are all the phases of the complete business system, how the entire business system is functioning, from in which you can connect now. Yesterday when we have discussed this, you would have got it, you would have not got it. Now you can connect. Before even which, let us go to this picture. Look at here, this picture. This is a holistic picture. Business understanding is a matter. Then once the business understand, context is understood, in and out of the business process is understood, then you can think of modeling. When you are trying to model feature engineering, data transformation, data binning, temporal analysis with respect to time, when anything you analyze that is temporal data with respect to time. Then text data, image data, feature selection. These all are related to feature engineering. Every data type the way of doing feature engineering, it differs. Model training. You need to develop algorithm or ensemble technique, or you need to go for hybrid technique, parameter tuning, retraining, model management, version control, feedback. See, this model management, it is closely integrated. Look at this monitoring, then all the stages together will play a role. From the monitoring, the feedback goes. From the feedback only, you need to maintain the entire model. This entire block, experiment block itself, I can say, model management. From the monitoring only, you can able to understand how well you need to manage. Model evaluation. Several techniques for the model evaluation. A-B testing, cross-validation, model reporting. Once the model is ready, you can go for data acquisition and understanding. Data source, pipelining. You may need to pipeline with the several stages of data. Data backup or data processing, in-memory processing, batch processing, like that. So pipelining, streaming versus batch, low versus high frequency. The velocity of the data, all together you need to take care only through pipelining. Next, environment, on-premise or cloud, database or data lake. Just now I said database is purely related to relational. What is data lake? It's a collection of all the databases, small versus medium versus big data. What environment you are working, whether you are working for small data or medium amount of data or big data. Then you need to go for ETL, almost I can say ETL, wrangling. Exploration, cleaning, structured versus unstructured data, whether you are dealing or data validation and cleaning and visualization. This almost we can say ETL. These all are inevitable. Once if these all done, only you can think of deployment. After deployment, again, the feedback model, that holistic picture, much more efficient. So everywhere interconnected. Then once it is deployed, you need to go for scoring, performance monitoring, dashboard or control room. Then this deployment side only, you need to go for model storage, web services. Web services only ultimately can interact with other web platforms, and web services only can interact with the human as well, the user interface, intelligent applications. Then finally, monitoring. Through monitoring, you can go for feedback, customer acceptance. Ultimately, whatever we are doing, customer need to get accepted. That is where you can end the entire process. Now, with these two, you can come back to this organization structures of business analytics. This is the whole process. These two you should understand. Only then you can go for organization structure of business analytics. Head of Advanced Analytics, COE. This I have taken it from Accenture website. So they function like this. Not necessary that data business analytics organization structure should follow the same. It is depending upon the process. What is the process they handle? You see, this is a holistic picture of the entire business system process. Depending upon that, we can go. COE support office. So this COE support office involved with recruitment, talent management, demand management. So they need to forecast. Project also they need to forecast. Manpower also they need to forecast. They need to calculate the existing manpower. They need to map with recruitment manpower, HR, analytics development, program managers, data scientists, solution architect, business analyst, developers, data acquisition managers. Everyone's roles and responsibility will vary. What is the role and responsibility? Here it comes. So this is the part where they are working, how much the technical extent they are working. That varies from everybody's role. Analytics support, model deployment, completely they need to take care of deploying the model either into the cloud or into their own server. Operation support, so they need to take care of all the internal operations together. There are different departments will be working, functioning. If you consider Amazon, they will be having freight services, they will be having cash transaction or money transaction. What is the mode of payment? There are several mode of payment they will be admitting. Then shipment and all the vendor connecting all the, this is business to business logic. Complete Amazon uses business to business logic. They will have tie up with yet another business. They do some business. So inventory filling, stock analysis, so many things. Then their own employee payroll, their own employee management. So several database together it is connected. So they need to take care of the internal operations. Data quality managers. So this data quality managers role only the data governance. They need to look at quality of the data, standards of the data, policies, auditing, security, authentication, profiling, roles, backup, retrieval, archive, purging. These all the role need to be taken care by data quality managers. Help desk, of course, help desk nowadays, bots. Most of the time, telecalling and bots automation is possible. Analytics platform. Then data mining, data warehousing, DWH data warehousing, data mining specialist, data architects, data operations manager. Next, data governance again. Here also it is revisited. Metadata design, data about data. Metadata or data summary also, metadata design, data complaints manager, data governance. These are all the role player of business analytics organization. The moment analytics plays a role into business, it is termed as business analytics. And what are all the levels of staffing, complete staffing or personal? So what are all the levels of the employees and how they will be working together cohesively? What is a pipeline of the employee performance model? All together, it is discussed today. With that, today I'm concluding. Then we will move on to one. You may not be able to conclude. I just give you one more snapshot of discussion. That quickly I will complete. Nothing to worry. Hope so. You can able to see talent database. Anyone please acknowledge 16 data mining techniques, the complete list. I just the beginning of the session listed out what are all the data mining techniques possible. Right now, see brief, very very short brief. This is sweet and elegant way to read what is business intelligence, what is data mining. You please read this article without fail. So I just share it in the chat window. Later on you can read. Even I will be sharing this document, nothing to worry. So I have shared in the chat window. 1 minute, let me assure. Yeah, it is shared. So make a note of that. See, look at here, data cleaning and preparation. What are all the data mining process associated into business organization or into business intelligence? Data cleaning and preparation, tracking patterns, classification, association, outlier deduction, clustering, regression, prediction, sequential patterns, decision tree, statistical technique, visualization technique, neural networks, data warehousing, long-term memory processing, in-memory processing, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. So these are all the possible data mining techniques. For each and every technique, data cleaning, preparation ultimately can be said as ETL, extra transform load, or data integration and aggregation, or data transformation. So this is where you need to take care. See, data governance, those who are all going to prepare on data governance, you can even refer this particular material. Data quality and the level of data and standards of the data, these all need to be checked. Tracking patterns, identifying and monitoring trends and pattern analysis. Trend analysis, ultimately we can say pattern analysis. Classification, association, these all a bit I discussed in the previous class as well and today as well. Outlier deduction, clustering, regression, prediction, sequential pattern, decision trees, all the statistical technique. At time, there are few business issues could be solved just by applying mean, applying standard deviation. It is possible. No need to think big. At time you need to think smaller also, but that will give effective solution. So that is where statistical technique plays a role. Visualization, neural network, data warehousing, long-term memory processing, machine learning, artificial intelligence, and other optimization techniques also available with data mining tools. Cloud and storage, future of the data mining, AutoML. This is related to AutoML. Then getting started with the data mining, if you wish, you can read. So this is what I wanted to convey. This material you need to undergo. This is important. With that, I'm concluding today's session. Then subsequently, Tuesday session, we'll be moving towards prescriptive analytics and its process and its modeling, all related to prescriptive. That's all. That word meant for prescriptive. Although I am discussing prescriptive, one unit is of time series analysis, one unit of prescriptive analytics. However, for the need of this unit, we need to address now introductory level at least. Then nonlinear optimization, these two would be touched upon in the subsequent session.